Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel and thanks for logging on. Today we're discussing the IWC Aquatimer 2000, reference 3536-02. You can see this titanium 2000 meter dive watch and purchase it on our website. Subscribe to our YouTube channel if you enjoy these videos and please click on the card in the upper right hand corner of the screen at any time during this video to see our full sales listing for this watch with additional accessories included in the sale, high resolution images for your desktop, and actually complete pricing details for this IWC Aquatimer 2000. Now this model had a relatively short lifespan, but it hails from a different era and design sensibility in Schaffhausen. Back before many of the oversized and some might say overwrought sports references of the present day, IWC tool watches were very utilitarian and one might even say purist instruments in the strictest sense. Now you can see the watch is 41.5 millimeters across the round of the case, not inclusive of the crown, big enough to get the message across, not so big that it becomes cumbersome, nor is the watch excessively thick, although its side is sheer and its bezel flares a bit. It's only 14.5 millimeters thick, remarkable considering the depth rating. There are two ways to measure this watch horizontally across the wrist. If you were to wear it commando style on a NATO strap or a textile of some variety, you would find that the distance between the hinges of the lugs is actually a very manageable 49.5. But because this watch is on a full titanium bracelet, you see that the links do flare out a bit, and this is as much as you can compress them. So the actual lateral distance across the wrist is going to be a much more substantial 57 millimeters when worn with the bracelet. That's why I'd say you can wear this watch on a 13.5 centimeter wrist on a strap. As is on the bracelet, I would say perhaps 15 centimeters, maybe 14.5 as the lower limit, but it is very light. The bezel, the case middle, the case back, the entire bracelet and clasp in titanium, and beautifully discreet. Not only is the watch not oversized and overbearing, but the bracelet and the case are all of satin finish that mutes the light. It has a gorgeous gray-blue beauty to it, and it's a handsome integration of lug and bracelet. It has a little bit of a Royal Oak vibe going on. You'll also note that it is a fully sizable bracelet. Inheritance from the GST sports watch line of the same time period, you can see that every single link of this modular bracelet is removable for supremely accurate and close sizing, or if you simply want to tear it down completely for close cleaning. Now, of course, this watch rated to 2,000 meters is as tough as that rating suggests, and in case you missed the message, there's the image of a submarine on the case back, most apropos. The watch features a bezel that has just the perfect amount of detent, enough resistance that it doesn't move easily, but not so much that you would have trouble getting a purchase on it and moving it when the time comes to align the luminescent index with the minute hand. Now you can time an event from 0 to 60 minutes. It might be a dive, it might just be pizza in the oven. The bottom line is, it's highly practical. I also want to call attention to the fact that this watch is a veteran. You can see evidence of its pre-owned status. It was used and enjoyed by its previous owner, and there are some marks on the case. There are some marks on the lugs and the bracelet. There are some marks on the bezel, because this is a tool watch and it was worn accordingly. In terms of water resistance and mechanical integrity, absolutely as good as the day it was made, but I do want to have some truth in advertising. So you can see that there are some marks on this pre-owned watch. Of course, you can see the original crown is also in place. This is an item that's frequently swapped out during service, so the watch maintains outstanding originality in that it features the original IWC fish crown, not the modern Probus service replacement crowns. You'll also note how generously knurled the bezel edge is. It's wonderful to grip it. It sounds good. It feels good. A bad bezel can wreck a great dive watch. Happily, that is not the case here. This one is a standard. By any measure, this is a great bezel. Moreover, the dial is no nonsense. White print on matte black. There's no glare. There's excellent contrast. Baton-style hands and indices. This one was made in the era after 2000. When IWC began to feature superluminova rather than tritium on its dive watches, so the watch glows beautifully in the dark to this day. It also features a discrete date window, so you have that practical information on a daily basis. The movement inside is an IWC 30,000 series, so it is an ETA 2892, and back in this era, IWC was still taking delivery of incomplete knockdown kits for movements, and then largely re-engineering, finishing them, and regulating them to IWC's chronometry standard. So you get a fantastic tough base caliber. I've basically crashed an ETA 2892A2 on a bike at 20 miles an hour, and the movement was still ticking even though I barely was. So I know how tough this base caliper is, automatic winding with a 42-hour power reserve. You can see hacking or stop seconds so you can synchronize to a reference time. It also has a quick set to cycle the date should the watch run down. So as tough and convenient and everyday reliable as that movement is, IWC takes hold of it and finished and regulated it to a standard such that this watch, when freshly serviced, is as good as any chronometer. It's also as tough as any dive watch out there. You can see and you can buy this classical IWC Aquatimer Automatic 2000 meter on our website.